Everybody knows about it, about Midhani. So I thought, I think better to interact and tell more about the problems and discuss about this. Because R&D and indigenization is the main heart and soul of Midhani, the whole. And particularly, Midhani has been manufacturing materials, of course. Everybody is talking about materials, the whole line. And one more thing I would like to tell about Midhani is I am not a direct beneficiary from any of the forces getting orders directly. I am the tier 3, the bottommost line. I also compete like other private players, many areas except for a few. So I supply to BHEL, who is already a customer to somebody. I supply to Bharat Singh. And of course, not much to GRSC and BEL, but of course, we are there in the bottom of the tier of the pyramid. Actually, we are there in the bottom of the tier of the pyramid in materials. As the problems that has been suffered or problems that has been taken at the starting point itself. Here, I would like to bring out, because the materials, people always look for materials in the last stage. They don't come to the last. When you get the order, look for the product. Then you start looking for the materials, what are the alloys. Then you go and sit in the market. So when you give an order for a material, immediately in the next minute, that is the first one you have to start with. You know, next minute onwards, you're running behind the material. So naturally, there are a lot of pressure for material manufacturing. This always goes on, not only with private, of course, with our friends also. So once I get order, the last minute I get the order, and finally, I'm the first to supply, otherwise deliveries will not be made. And one more thing I would like to bring out is Midhani makes all materials are 100% indigenous. There is no import part in it. Because it's a basic material. So here, what I want to bring out R&D part in indigenization part in the product is, so when you start indigenizing product, you look for the material. And the material means you look for the alloy. The alloy has to be indigenized. When you have to, do the indigenize the alloy, then you have to develop the technology. So you have to develop your own technology. The most problematic is, after developing technology, you don't have equipment to make the product. When you don't have equipment to make the product, you have to import the equipment or make yourself. So many of the equipments, like vacuum induction furnaces and all, are not being made in India, so you have to import. Or electroslag remelting, or all these furnaces. So again, the problem of import. Because I also get into the same trouble of import to start with. So we, Midhani, started manufacturing the furnaces. That is the first thing we thought. Why running behind getting import license and getting into troubles? I struggled almost 12 months to get an import license for a vacuum arc melting furnace and an ESR furnace. At that time, we decided why we cannot make our own furnace. It's a risk. Let's not make a furnace of 5 ton or something. Let's go for 10 tons because market needs a lot of materials. So we went and we manufactured. And we manufactured at half of the price. So unless otherwise, you take risk, you take the importance, you show what effort you have to put to import the material, unless otherwise you face that, you can't get into it. Once I made one 10-ton furnace, today we are ready to make 20-ton furnace. It is an Indian electroslag remelting furnace, which is the key of the barrel manufacturing and as well as key of the super alloy manufacturing. That means we have to go to the root of the thing to start the concept of indigenization. This is the first point which I thought. I think every one of us had to look, can we make in India? Can we make the product in India? You know, immediately what we say, so and so, we go to website and check, immediately you find 5 or 6 companies where it is making. First of all, think of yourself whether can you make in India? Can you make with an Indian equipment? I think we are very good in making Jugaad. Why we cannot make a Jugaad with that we make? Maybe first time we may fail. Second time we may fail for making of it. Third time onwards will be definitely successful. That is what I have seen at least in the last 7-8 years of running Midhani. Many equipments we have made ourselves without importing. So that is where we started making our own indigenous production. And second, the most important thing is materials. People always say that yesterday also I understand we talked we don't get good materials. We don't get materials in India like super alloys and all. Yes. Sir, material manufacturing is a long-term job. Fabrication, I can create a fabrication industry within 3 to 4 months. How much you want? 100 tons, 200 tons, we can do it. A machining center, you can create within 1 year. But a manufacturing of steel or super alloys, it takes at least 3 years. Because those equipment manufacturing itself is going to 2 years, 1 year for commissioning. All that, I'm not taking the counting of the purchase, tendering and all, I'm not counting. At least 3 years to manufacture an equipment. And come into your place. And sorry, start an equipment at your place. So lead time is 3 years. Will you wait for it? That's where the tension starts. This is what I have seen 6-7 years back. Today, Midhani is equipped in full. Maybe another 2 months, everything is in full 100%. We are ready to take the challenge of Indian requirements of either super alloy you call a titanium alloy, or you call a specialized steel, anything. In competition, actually that I can tell you, that competing the foreign price, except if foreign market is also down, like today we have seen all the material manufacturing in the foreign market are already slumping down. You talk about Tyson Group or Abadual, all are making not profits, their losses. So in that competition, we can stand. I'm sure we can stand and make the material available for the Indian market without any problem. Starting from the root of manufacturing equipment. This is what our way of indigenization effort. And third thing is R&D. Midhani, actually what happens is, anybody is getting difficulty of getting any material, particularly in either call it super alloy, specialized alloys. They come to me, any product also sometimes, they say that Midhani is there, we'll go and take it. And Midhani never says no to it. And we failed, we went in losses, but still we made the product and supplied, because these strategic industries you don't get from anywhere. You have to make it. Our motto of the prime concern is, we have to make it. How? That's the technology you have to develop yourself and do it. And of course, we get a lot of support from our requirement of the customers itself. And fourth point, which I thought I'll bring out, is yesterday they came out, is testing. This is a big issue. When I go into the competing in the market, sometimes, let me tell you, when I compete, titanium alloy itself, I compete in the market. When I put my titanium rod and everything in the market, and there is a trader gets a material there with available with him, maybe 500 kgs of some rods with a test certificate there, and I have to quote against him. The 500 kg for supply from my side, I have got a lot of testings I have to show it. I have to show where I am melting, which material I am melting, and because after getting the order, I have to start. Not the beforehand. That other material, trader material, is available at the stock. It is available. But for me, I have to start after getting the order, show that the whole thing to our testing, our regulating authorities, forge, show it to the regulating authority, finish showing to the regulating authority and supply. There are so many steps of things which I am supposed to do to make the test certificate. Whereas other side, it's available. And what is that cost that is going to take it up? My cost will definitely go up. Definitely, I can't put at the price. But if you ask me 500 tons, keep it there. I can make it the best price and keep it there. I can show the total product. I can proactively work and then keep it, stocking it. But that is not allowed in a company like us, stocking it. Of course, you stock it. If you cannot sell it, you land into many problems. Because a public sector is not I don't get money. I have to live on my own money. So I cannot make stock like that. So this test certificates is another issue which we are also facing problem. Of course, for that, the basic thing, that other one, we have to have a testing center, which Bharat was been mentioning about it, is we have to create a testing center. Of course, there are some efforts are going on from Ministry of Defense itself is planning to have a testing center of its own, naval testing center and some testing centers that are expanding the aeronautical material testing center and a full-fledged way. So if the testing center is there, independent testing center run by the testing authorities, anybody can go and test their product and get it evaluated and do it, so that you get your test certificate, whatever is correct or not, you will come to know. That is essentially the test certificate. Another point is Make in India is the concept which everybody was talking. It's like a slogan, it is going on. And people are interpreting their own way of things. Is it Make in India means not that exactly everything is Make in India and do it. Not only that. Suppose you can import material, manufacture and supply back. It's Make in India. Let's elaborate the whole thing. You know, like a terms of reference, let us say that what is Make in India, the concept. Import and export, that's all. You are making in India. That is how China started the whole thing in the market initially. It's not the same one. This is the way they started initially in the whole market. And another, I think last and final, one more point I would like to bring out is, there is a notion about PSUs, public sector undertakings. There's a notion. Sir, I want to tell you that public sector undertakings are also run in a similar way as the private sector it runs. There are certain problems, shackles, some chains and all are there, which yesterday, I think RM has clearly mentioned there are shackles, which he is going to release the shackles. If shackles are removed, definitely it is going to come out like an work like another private industry. I don't say compete, it comes like a private industry. And when we in public sectors, when we are processing, don't think that we're doing everything inside, sir. As our people have been mentioning, that a lot of outsourcing activity. A simple example, two examples I'll tell you, I'll not go more than that. One example I'll tell you. We are making welding electrodes. Midhani never makes welding electrodes. It's completely a different line. We have made a welding electrodes for Arihant. The complete first Arihant launching, we have supplied around 380 tons of welding electrodes, and later, of course, four more boards we have been making. And we made 380 electrodes, welding electrodes. The basic raw material, the welding wire, is the criticality, because the chemistry of the welding wire is the most important one, which we melted. We melted. Then we got it forged and rolled outside. We have not done inside. There's an outside party. There's an indoor party, or there's a Lunavala, somebody is there who we do forging at one place and then take it to another rolling someplace and bring it back, check chemistry and metallography every place. And again, we give it to an outsider for manufacturing welding electrodes. L&T makes, Advani, everybody makes. Midhani do not need to make. But to have the purity of metal, sometimes we have to go for it. And in that, I can tell you, 80% is outsourced only. 20%, because chemistry has to be retained, I had to do it. Otherwise, it would have been done. This is what any PSU runs it. Because I have core competence in melting and making an alloy. And I don't have any core competence of making another welding electrode, doing rolling and all. I can get it done. So this is how PSUs are running. This is how PSUs have to run, and PSUs are running in the similar tone. In that concept, in the same concept, the recently we have come out a consortium. You must have made her heard. The five submarines that are getting to market, that's 60,000 crores or whatever is going to come out. We thought, myself, I think Midhani and BHEL and HSL, Hindustan Shipyard Limited, with the three, because three different core competent people in three different areas came together. Why not we make? Mine is a material, and he takes care of fabrication. Retrofitting is done by HSL, one of the best shops which we have. There are two things it can happen. One, the consortia is going to give out a lot of strength, because in this consortia, only I use my core strengths. I had to go out for rolling, rod making or sheet making, everything. And similarly, BHEL also will go into its own outsourcing, and HSL also. We can do only 30 to 35% in the total. The balance 65% is outsourced only. Completely outsourced. We cannot have more than our core competence. So that definitely it is going to be one of the biggest objects that is going to come out. That is what we thought we are there in the race. I can tell you, we are sure. Not only that, second, BHPV, a SIC unit, BHP, which BHL is, can be pulled out, turn around. And HSL, which is already considered, you know, we don't have to ask money. You give the job. That is what we would like to ask and get the whole concept come into true. Is one of the Make in India concept completely inside. And that is what we thought we'll come out and say and get it. So that is why I said that Make in India, it should be something like a vaccine into the body. It should be a vaccine into the body so that no import should come. Only everything should be Make in India. Some sort of a thing which we have to create in every individual. Unless otherwise we do that, it is very difficult to bring the concept into reality. But it's happening everywhere. You know, suppose we see the materials have to be produced and go everywhere and come back. Like we see, you know, many of the, sometimes we see the shirts, ready-made shirts. When you go into US and start opening the ready-made shirt, you see made in Bangladesh and made in India. And we buy and sometimes we get it. Things can happen, it go around. And sometimes in Dell, in the computer, you give a 1800 something and all, maybe next door of your, maybe answering your problem. Similar thing, I expect things should happen in other fields or also in materials or metals or products everywhere. so that our product will be coming back to us again in a chance of using it. This is what we are looking at. This is a dream of ours, should get into a Make in India as a concept successful. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Narayan Rao, for sharing your thoughts and really